Career growth is something everyone who is a professional wishes to achieve, to get to a certain extent, height in their chosen profession. But how does this really work? What is the place of sponsorship and mentorship in career growth? How important are they? What is the difference and what roles do they play? We're joined this morning to talk about this by a global human resource professional. I'm talking about Oyedamola Osi. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Let's start with the differentiation. What's sponsorship? What is mentorship? And how do they merge when it comes to career development?
Okay, so people don't get it, but I will say that, you know, there's a clear and distinctive difference between, you know, a mentor and a sponsor. And I will even say that, you know, sponsors are must-have and mentors could be, you know, they are nice to have. So a sponsor is someone that takes your matter into rooms that, you know, you're not allowed to enter in the workplace. A sponsor is someone that advocates for you, that speaks for you in closed doors. While, you know, a mentor is someone that just, you know, help you to skill up. Your mentor doesn't necessarily have to speak for you in closed-door meetings and advocate for you. So often than not, I see that a lot of people mix it up. You know, they look to a mentor for things that they're supposed to look for in a sponsor. And when they don't get it, then, you know, they come to say, you know, the process is, you know, ineffective and it's not credible. So today I would like people to know that what you really need in the workplace to, you know, propel your career, to move you forward, is truly a sponsor. Because there are a lot of times that, you know, you're not going to be there when they discuss promotion, when they talk about, you know, advancement. It's that person who is your sponsor that will speak for you and, you know, allow people to see the good in you and which can also, you know, propel you for the next level in your career.
A lot of young Nigerians have a different definition of a sponsor, but let's focus on what we're talking about today. Does this create in any way, there's a narrative around Nigeria that success is really based on who you know, not, you know, your certification or, you know, how much you've studied. So does, you know, the idea of a sponsor create an unfair, you know, balance in the workplace? Does it, you know, give, you know, faster growth rates to people who may not even be qualified enough for certain positions against those who have the qualifications?
No, not at all. That's not, you know, the work of a sponsor. First, for you to even be sponsorable at the beginning, you have to be a top performer. And, you know, when I'm talking about sponsorship, I'm not talking about, you know, people that are not qualified getting into the workplace. I'm saying you're already qualified, you're already in the organization, and then you have the, you know, you have the skills and the capacity, but, you know, you are buried in the work. Nobody sees you. Nobody, you don't see what is in my heart. You don't see my capacity if I don't show it. So your sponsor is just someone showing to the other top stakeholders the value that you have made up. So for you to even be sponsorable, you have to be a top performer. That's like, you know, the number one rule of you being sponsorable. So it doesn't, it's not, so be, having a sponsor in the workplace, it's not the same as maybe you're not qualified and you're just, you know, churning in unqualified people into the workplace. No.
I guess the simplest must be way to
valuable and, you know, highly recommendable.
Yeah, but you can't take away, you know, that part of it, you know, from our society and from what truly happens.
But there, that is not the
people who,
yes.
Yeah, I get that. I'm just saying there's people who have these sponsors, people who speak on their, you know, behalf, you know, in you know, those offices and in those boardrooms. That these sponsors are only there because, you know, Nigeria is a place that has tribe, that has religion, that has a lot of these factors that come into play here. So how do you, you know, manage, you know, a sponsor who's speaking because, yes, I know this person has the qualifications and is skilled enough for these positions and is skilled enough to be promoted, and separate that from the people who are saying, yes, they are skilled, yes, they have the qualifications and all of that, but because they belong to my church, that's why I'm doing it. Because they're from my tribe, that's why I'm doing it.
Okay, and to reply to that question, look, not even in Nigeria, but 84% of the workplace all over in the world, you know, when you talk about meritocracy, it's a bit of a myth. And it's not just a Nigerian factor, it's, you know, it's everywhere. So I will say that having sponsors to propel you, it's not the same as saying that I'm propelling who is not qualified. Sponsors tend to also, everybody wants to be in the corner of the winning corner. I don't want to personally sponsor someone who is not doing the good work. I know that we might have that, you know, that problem, a little bit of problem, not even in Nigeria, let me say in the whole of Africa, to say that people try to push people that are not very qualified. But what I would say is that sponsors really want to be in the corner of people that are winning. I want to see my sponsee having the capacity, you know, to also grow in that promotion or grow in that career line that I'm, you know, propelling them for. And let's be realistic. Business owners, all of them also want to, everybody wants to make profit. Everybody wants the organization to fly. So ideally, in the real world, you will not really propel or promote or try to sponsor someone that are not good enough. Everybody wants, because at the end of the day, it comes back to the organization if you try to promote people that are not, you know, of high caliber.
All right, let's talk about the point at which a sponsor is needed. You said, I think I read a piece that you wrote, that everyone at some point in their career will require a sponsor. Please, could you explain at what point in people's career is a sponsor required?
Okay, so I will say that, you know, at the point whereby, you know, from your mid-level to your senior level, you will need to have a sponsor, because at that point, everybody's doing good work. You know, doing the good work is the basics. So it comes to a point whereby, what's going to make the difference? Everybody, we are all in the room, we all have the capacity, we are all doing good work. So what will make a difference for you to get that promotion, to be on that project, is when your sponsor is in that room, you know, when they say carrying your paper, you know, taking your matter and saying this person has done this, and the person is good. So from your mid-level career up until when you rise to that senior level, you absolutely need to have a sponsor. I have a sponsor, and I'm not shy to say that I do have a sponsor, and I do good work.
Okay, but if, sorry, Osaroge, if you say a sponsor is important, what about those who thrive without sponsors? Would you say that their achievement is not as important because they do not have sponsors? And why is the conversation about around sponsors necessary at this time?
Okay, you of course, you know, there is, like I said, because you have a sponsor, you must offer support, do good work. But believe me, people that do, you know, bury their head in the work and just do good work and assume that, I'm praying that someone is going to see my work, they can do so much more with if they have a sponsor. I mean, you could have much more promotion or much more advancement in your career with a sponsor. A sponsor is going to help you to move up. Believe me, there are people moving up three steps just because they have a sponsor. So you, it's not you getting down, burying your hand in the work and doing your work. We get you some level of result. But I will say that if you have a sponsor, you will get you much more result, and you will see, you know, you will see how your career will fly. And this is not saying that there is no place for good work or there is no space for hard work. There is still a space for good and hard work. You will do the work. You're just helping, you're just, you know, facilitating your advancement, your career advancement. And I think in this competitive world, we all need it.
It's safe to say that, you know, if I had a sponsor a lot earlier, I probably would have been in my New York bureau office now, obviously in the city, but here I am. But Oyindamola, I want to ask, for everyone who's listening and saying, yeah, I like this idea, how do I attract a sponsor? How do I become a magnet for a sponsor? Is it based on my work, or is there certain things that I must do to position myself in the workplace that, of course, I get to see these sponsors every now and then that would speak for me?
Okay, so first, to make it clear, sponsors are not, you know, sitting down in the office cafe looking around for, you know, sponsors or proteges. No, first and first, you know, you have to be a top performer. You have to, that's the basic. You have to do good work. You have to be, you know, you have to be competent in what you do. And, you know, being confident is then not enough. So you have to do something that we call positioning. It's the same when, you know, a guy is trying to, you know, be in the face of a girl. You know, in the old days, you probably go to a house, stroll the street, hoping that her mom will send her somewhere and she'll see you. So it's the same thing, you know, in the workplace. You have to show yourself. positioning and showing yourself. So those are the things, those are part of the things that you need to do. You are the top performer, you position yourself for those sponsors to see you and be like, okay, this person does good work. And then that means you create visibility around your skill set. Whatever it is that you're doing, you are leading a project, don't just leave the project, you know, buried up down. You talk about it, you show yourself. Now organizations have workplace and workplace apps that they used to communicate. There's nothing wrong in saying, oh, I was sitting on this project and this is what we do. It's all about creating visibility around your skill set. So those are part of the things that you will do to attract the sponsor. Not all the time that you will go to say, can you be my sponsor? 85-90% of the time, the sponsor will come to you to say, okay, but there's a lot you can do to position and create visibility around your skill set to make the sponsor come for you.
I'm not trying to be a clog in the wheel, but it has to be asked. What if, no matter what you do, the sponsor is not convinced that in spite of, in your estimation, you've done quite a bit, and then the sponsor is not convinced, not one, not two, maybe not three. What happens to that person who doesn't seem to satisfy the requirement for getting a sponsor?
Thank you for asking me that question, because it's true, it's life. Because you position yourself or you create visibility around your work doesn't mean that a sponsor is going to come flying and to say, oh, yes, you do good work, come, can I be your sponsor? No, sometimes you can do all that and nobody just seems to, they don't just seem to see you. So I would say three things. One is either, you are not as valuable as you think you are, or the organization doesn't, you might have that value, but the organization doesn't see you like that. That can be one. And the second thing is, you might just be approaching the wrong people. The people you're approaching might just not be the right people. So I would say for you to, to go into trying to position yourself to get a sponsor, you have to do some bit of background work, which means you need to map out my organization. Okay, I'm in Plus TV. Who are the key stakeholders? Who are the people that have influence? Who are the people that matter? Who are the people that also have credibility amongst their peers, that when they talk, people listen? Those are the people you should gun for. And if you go for those people and still they don't seem to want to sponsor you, you can ask why. Because that's good feedback for you. It might also mean that you need to go back and, do more work. So that's what I'll say.
Mr. Ladende is our sponsor here. I want to ask about, there are two things I'm going to throw at you. I think we're running out of time, but I want to ask about, now that you've mentioned how important this is for persons who, are positioning themselves well, who are doing what it takes to ensure that they have the certification, they have the skill set, to always be favorable in the eyes of a sponsor. How do you then advise someone who might be getting sexual invitations, in offer for, exchange for some level of sponsorship in the workplace? She wants to grow, or he wants to grow. He knows that he has worked hard enough, but, there are those roadblocks here and there, that, of course, come with sexual invitations. And also, a mentor and a sponsor, can they be the same person?
Okay, so to answer your question on the sexual harassment, I mean, we are not going to say that we are not, that's not a reality. But I would say that, if that comes to the table, then, you'll be firm and say, this is not the reason. I mean, I believe that I'm capable, I'm a professional, and this is not why I'm asking for this relationship. I'm not going to, if you cannot, judge me based on my skills and based on my competences, then, this is not the kind of mentorship relationship I'm starting to look for. You can't control how the other person, takes it off you. You can only control yourself and control, you can only control yourself and control how you respond to the situation. So you will say, this is not the kind of relationship I want to build. I'm a professional, I want you to help me in this light. If that's not what you are up for, then, this is not, I'm not going to be able to go into that sort of relationship with you. And then you'll be fine. And, you just excuse yourself from such situation. And then on the other hand, saying that, can mentors also be also be the same time? Can we have the same person having been a mentor and a sponsor? I would say most of the time it's not. They are two different, they are two standalone different people, because majorly your sponsor has to be someone in your organization. And mentors doesn't necessarily have to be someone in your organization. In some percent, 5-10%, they can be the same person. Somebody's mentoring you, and then they can also sponsor you. I mean, that would be fantastic, because somebody mentoring you knows you very well. They are providing you tailor-made solution to advance your career. And that person also can also be raising your name, raising your the card of your name in rooms that you can be. So if you are lucky to have that one, two in one, I'm happy for you. But in most cases, you might not get those two things in one person.
Okay, and just to reiterate, you may also want to speak on this. The most important part of this whole space is working hard enough and building your profile and ensuring that you are strategically positioned in order to gain the eyes of someone who would likely be a sponsor. So I want you to go back to that. The most vital part of this for a person in the workplace, I guess, is hard work and increasing your skill set, right?
Hard work, increasing your competencies and your skill set, and creating visibility around those skill sets. It's not just increasing it and then you're increasing it and then you're not doing it, nobody knows about it. Hard work, increasing your competencies and creating visibility around those competencies and positioning yourself so that those sponsors can see. You could be positioning yourself for project in your organization. It could even be some CSR project. It could be, now we are in the Christmas period. It could be that, Christmas party or Christmas gathering is important to your organization. It could be you positioning yourself to be part of the team, to lead the team. Positioning yourself is also key. So those are what I was. And lastly, you need to identify someone of influence. That's when your sponsorship quest will work.
Quickly also share, you're a HR person. Quickly also share some of the things that would be beneficial for someone in trying to grow in their career. How important is extra certification every now and then, maybe every year, every 2 years? How important is having a great LinkedIn page? How important also is on-ground training in your career? Because strategic positioning and also being strategic with your growth path, something that a lot of people are not very aware of.
Okay, thank you for asking that. Even for me personally, I take my personal growth very, very serious. So I would say that as the world continues to grow and everywhere seems to be in a global village, and having competencies that can separate you from the crowd is just a must-have. You need to be able to, it could be something as nipple or as little as learning a different language. It could be something as little as just taking an online courses. Now, everything is, I always say, I wish that I was out of school fresh at this level. I wish that, because there's so much opportunity. So we need to take it. So once in a while, it could be an online course. It could be, sitting down learning. It could be classroom learning. You need to continue learning. Learning is, you need to do, because now you are competing with, and I say it every time, you are competing with the whole world. Because right about now, even COVID has shown us that I can be sitting here in Dubai. I sit here in Dubai, I manage 8 countries in Africa. I mean, I'm competing with people in Africa for my job. I'm competing with people here, and they are also competing with me. Everybody wants to take everybody's job right about now. You could be in Nigeria, and your company can be in China. That's the world we are in.
Fair enough. Indeed, COVID-19 has indeed changed the whole work environment. We thank you very much for joining us and sharing your thoughts on The Breakfast. It's appreciated.
Hello, hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.